Welcome one and all to The Last Flame. My name is Deep Space Matt, and today I'm assembling a roster of fantasy heroes, forging the best weapons and items I can find, and strategically placing them on the battlefield to fight through increasingly challenging enemies. With countless synergies and builds to discover, and many paths and choices to make, can I find the right combination for victory? Let's find out in The Last Flame. Alright, here we go with The Last Flame. This is an upcoming roguelike auto battler that is set to release on January 17th. However, there is a free prologue version coming out earlier on the 8th of January, so you'll be able to download and play that for free in about a week from now. And the prologue will contain more content than the demo currently has. So if you want to check this game on out, or the prologue, I'll have links to both in the description down below. It is worth noting that what you see here is an early build of the full game. Shout out to Hot Loop for allowing me to showcase this game early. And with that said, let's get right into it and play. Alright, looks like we have Ascension and then Endless and Challenge, both of which are locked. Novice, enemy difficulty is 1 skull, heal after boss 90, and Rage Timer default. Do we not have other difficulties here? Ascension is the normal game mode in The Last Flame. Beat a difficulty to unlock the next one, as well as other game modes. Okay, so we do want the tutorial on. We will embark. In this tutorial, you will receive a few objectives to complete, which will explain the basics of The Last Flame. You can accomplish them in any order. Don't feel rushed to do them as soon as they appear. At all times, you can press on tab or on the book at the bottom right corner to open the guidebook. You can also click on an objective to open the guidebook at the corresponding tip. Very nice. Oh, look at all the characters we got here. Heroes. Heroes start with a passive and active and unique stats. Okay, we have HP, we got mana. Passive and active, every attack generates 1 mana. Mana regen generates mana passively over time. Heroes cast their abilities, their active ability, when their mana bar is full. You can view all your current heroes in the hero panel, keybind H, or click on the helmet in the bottom right corner. While hovering over any tooltip, you can press tab or middle mouse button to display its advanced tooltip. It will search for all relevant keywords in the glossary and display them. Oh, that is great. Alright, pick 2 heroes. We have Zico, Azura, Gerald, Vinrak, and Naka. What do they all do? Hero gains 1% lifesteal per 4% missing HP, forms a flip strike to his current target with a bonus of 200% attack damage. If above 65% max HP, consumes and gains more attack damage. So he likes getting hurt. The hero gains 1 spell power for every 150 max HP, so you like having a lot of health. Throws a lightning spear at the target, dealing damage to all enemies hit, and gains 15 max HP for every shock on her target. So I can click on this and find out what shock is. Oh, look at that. A debuff that scales well with stuns and fast casting heroes. On cast, heroes have a 1.5% chance per shock to stun their current target for 1 second. There's a lot going on here. Increase the duration of other stuns. So she shocks and stuns is the basics, I suppose. Lightning spear also scales with bonus max HP. Every time the hero crit strikes with an attack, it gains 5 gold. Ooh, what do we use gold for? Used to buy items at the shop. Oh, that should be good. Trophies used to rank up your heroes. 1 trophy equals 5 XP. That is good as well. If this value reaches 0, you lose the run. Okay, so I like having more gold to buy stuff. Critical forging. Nearby heroes gain crit strike chance for 5 seconds. Ooh, that sounds good. The hero gains 20 ethereal amplification when the fight starts. Vinrak casts Full Moon, he gains ethereal amplification and attack speed. Full Moon lasts for X attacks equal to half of his max mana. I like that as well, that looks great. When gaining a shield from any source, gain attack speed. Okay, I don't think we have anybody giving shields at the moment. Naka performs a sword dance, dealing damage to nearby enemies, inflicting 2 bleeds. In addition, Naka also gains a shield, so he gives himself shield, which will give him attack speed. 1% attack speed for each hero and summon on the battlefield stacks 50 times. That's actually pretty nice as well. I kind of like that. Both of these have red backgrounds. I'm not sure if that is related. Shield mastery, bleed debuff, crit mastery, providing support. Yeah, I don't know if they're like the classes. Like these are attack classes, but we're gonna go with Gerald for sure, and maybe I guess Naka. Or you're great as well. No, we're gonna go with Naka here. All right, now we choose a relic. 30% discount on everything at the shop. Elites lose 18% health when the fight starts. You can now research at the campfire. Research chooses a relic. It uses two campfire actions. After each fight, you heal for 3 and get an additional trophy. Oh, that sounds great. We're doing that one. Juicy Mango. Oh, look at this. Act 1, Illuzio Forest. Are we being accused or are we choosing? I choose you. Oh, hello. Okay. Oh, wow. Look at this. It shows you the path of the possible paths you can take by highlighting them. That is amazing. This is some kind of event, although I don't know what these are. Like when I hover over them. Oh, never mind. There's a key. I should have looked slightly to the left. Yes, an event here. And then we have an elite. Oh, but we have like no shop on this side. We have no campfire until we get over here. That seems awful. You know what? I guess we'll take this route, hit the campfire here, and then maybe come here and hit a shop right before the boss. Oh, and it X's out all the ones. I love that little animation. That was nice. You can drag heroes to place them on other hexes. The last hero to be dropped from an enemy will redirect the enemy's focus to this hero. It only works if it is a nearby hex to an enemy. This is very useful to choose which heroes are getting targeted by which enemies. Wait a minute. The last hero to be dropped. Okay, so yeah, you put one, and the next one you put, then the enemy will attack that one. You can also have up to 5 heroes on the battlefield. During the preparation phase, you can swap your current heroes with heroes on the bench. Right-click on a hero or an enemy to open their character panel. This is especially important to learn the enemy's abilities. Alright, so what do we got here? We have a giant bug. 600 increases all enemies' attack speed by 10%. Doesn't do much, it just attacks. And we have both of our fellas here who just, you want to get into it, right? So we're just gonna, wait, who has the most health? 1250 and 1300. So we can move, so we can't move you there. We can move you over here. Fight info, all enemies gain, oh, enraged timer, lost per death. All enemies gain 15% attack speed, attack damage, spell damage, and some tenacity. After being activated, the enrage effect is repeated every 5 seconds. Alright, let's do it. Get some. Alright, and what do we get? We get some gold. That was gold, right? Yeah. Gold, we repair, we can recruit a hero, we can pick an item. Just grab this. Igar. Every second attack inflicts 1 burn or 1 frost at random to all enemies? Hello. When below 50% HP, attacks consume 2 frosts to heal. Ooh. Igar throws his boomerang axe, dealing damage in a line. Boomerang axe deals 5% additional damage per burn on the enemy. I kind of like that. Emily, Astral Sword. The hero's attacks deal additional ethereal damage. Emily casts Great Sword of Light, dealing damage in a line. For each enemy hit, Emily gains 5 spell power. If only one enemy is hit, she gains ethereal amplification instead. Every time the hero heals the hero, oh, it's a healer. Oh, I might want to pick Rose, actually. I like Igar, but the healer sounds great. All heroes gain 2 spell power. Rose casts Divinity, healing allies in the heal area. Yes. Okay, we need a healer, so we're going to pick that. We can get an item. Ooh, attack speed and spell power. Or, ooh, crit strike chance. Oh, we want this one, right? Because one of our characters loves crit strike. We get another one. Attack speed sounds great. And then can we place these on our heroes in here? I'm guessing in these slots on the right. So Gerald, Every time the hero crit strikes with an attack, it gains 5 gold. Right, Gerald is the one who likes to crit. So, like that, very nice. And then also, I mean, if we give you attack speed, you're going to be attacking more often, which gives more potential procs for critting. So we're just going to put it all on you. And then we can see you got 18... Well, hold on, you over here. 10 base plus 25% bonus. Where are you getting this bonus from? How come you don't get a bonus? I mean, you're getting the 8% from this. Sure. But it's good. Lots of crits are great. All right, let's close this out. I think that's all we do here. So we just proceed. Move on to the next one. Oh, this giant spider. Oh, you look awful. It deals spell damage to its target. What about you in the back here? Your quick arrows. All right, so we kind of want... We're just going to do the same thing. We're going to maybe deal with the spider first. 660 and 640. Yeah, we're just going to deal with the spider first. Let's go get it. All right, very nice. Get some money, recruit a hero. Oh, look at XZ09. I just want you because you look cool. When the hero gets or is above 50% max HP, they gain a shield. And XZ09 goes into super mode, increasing its lifesteal and attack speed for 5 seconds and taunting its current target. Every time the hero crit strikes with an attack, they summon a water elemental. If 3 water elementals are already summoned, increase their attack damage by 2. Cast Leech Life, draining X percent from each of his water elementals' HP to heal for the same amount. And hero inflicts 1 frost on enemies. Crit strikes inflict 1 frost on enemies. Man, a lot of crit stuff. Hold on. We go to here. And this here, nearby heroes gain crit strike chance. So, I kind of want you here, since you'll get buffed. I mean, sorry, XZ09. But, we're on the crit train, I suppose. We're doing all of that. Every 3 attacks, the wearer gains 1 attack damage per summon on the battlefield. 50% ethereal amplification. When the wearer receives damage from any source, they have a 25% chance to inflict burn on all enemies. Very interesting. Can I look at this? I can. We don't have the burn person. We pass them up. But we can go... Let's go with a sharp saber. Forging allows you to choose the attributes of your items. You can open the forging window with F or by clicking on the hammer and anvil at the bottom right corner. Got it. Forge an equipable item by combining a recipe with an heirloom. The forged item has the effect of both the recipe and the heirloom. Okay, so we have... Oh, I see. This is what we just got. So we don't actually have that. This was a recipe. So we need to combine it. So we can give this to one of these things. I feel like the sharp saber, every 3 attacks, adding to an attack speed, seems great. Forge it together. And then we can just place this back on you. All right, and let us proceed. Reroll tutorial 4, reroll an item reward. Active and passive abilities and effects can apply debuffs on enemies. Debuffs are displayed above the enemy's health bar. Debuffs in the Last Flame are quite unique as they all synergize with specific damage types or stuns rather than dealing damage or having effects on their own. So bleed scales well with attack damage and crit strikes. Frost scales with spell damage, burn with attack speed and ethereal damage, shock with stuns and fast casting. Oh, and this is all the things they do. Okay, yeah, so like if you do frost, it increases spell damage. So the burn, so like burn doesn't actually burn the enemy. It just gives a buff to the heroes that deal ethereal damage. All right, got it. We also want to reroll an item reward, just because the tutorial says so. Who do we got back here? Oh, these are the giant bugs. Okay, that's fine. We're gonna put you here. How much health do you have? 1350. Sure, you can go in last. You'll get attacked. We're gonna put you just in the back line here and get it going. Oh, there's our water elemental. We're gonna heal. Looks great. All right, grab this, recruit a hero, Orion. Every two attacks, the hero inflicts one shock. Orion deals concussion strike to its current target, stunning the target for 2 seconds and taunting it. It also heals. Sounds great. Joanna, when the fight starts, the hero summons two blue drakes, which do not attack and die. When the hero dies, the hero gains 4 spell power per summon on the battlefield. You right here, because you're going to be summoning. Yeah, you're summoning water elementals up to 3. And you gain 4 spell power per summon. I'm assuming that's not her summons, just any summons. And then cast Blizzard, dealing damage to enemies hit and inflicting frost. Every attack, the hero gains 4% attack speed. Aria fires a frozen arrow on her current target, dealing damage to enemies hit, inflicting 3 frost. Okay, we're not on the frost train either. Although you do frost as well. But you're summoning. So we're gonna work on summons as well. We can pick an item and attack speed, attack damage. I mean, I like these things, but it wants us to reroll. So I'm just gonna reroll. Attack speed and crit strike. Oh, never mind. That was good. I want this right here. And these are positive plus negative, but this sounds great. Attack speed and crit strike. I know exactly the one person this is going on. There's another one here. Attack damage and attack speed. And we can go with the pistol as well. I mean, the other character we had has a lot as well. We're going to go with the Novus bow. More damage. And we're going to place this one over here. Now you're at 30. Okay, you're down to 10. I guess you're getting a buff from Gerald over here, is what it was. And then you can get some extra damage. Hold on, take it off real quick. How do I take this off? Oh, nope, not there. I mean, I can put it on somebody else, I suppose. Okay, you have a base 80. So yeah, we're just gonna pump you up. You're gonna do even more damage. Sounds great. All right, let us... Okay, forge, right? We got nothing to forge. No, proceed. Oh, look at these. Click on the trophy icon to enter and leave trophy mode or hold T. While in trophy mode, click on a hero to give him a trophy. Additionally, you can middle mouse click on a hero to give him a trophy. Does not require to be in trophy mode. Ranks 2 and 4 grant a new random passive. All other ranks grant an attribute increase. You can drag items on your heroes to equip them. In the hero panel, you can unequip an item by double click on it. Answered my question. You can drag an item onto other items to swap them. Pressing shift will display the hero's items above their health bar. From this interface, items can be dragged, swapped, and equipped. Oh, this is amazing. Little quality of life things like this, where you can just... You can do this and do it straight on the battlefield without having to go into a menu is amazing. Holding control while dragging an item will select all items on the hero. On drop, it will swap all items from one hero to another. That is great. I love it. Rank up a hero and then go to the campfire, which is a while. Oh, I know. I guess it's right here. We're going to that one. Okay. Use to rank up your heroes. Click to enter trophy mode. So we're in trophy mode. So let's get... Oh man, who's who? Okay, you're Gerald. Let's get Gerald up. How much am I using? 1 = 5 experience. Sure. reached rank 2. Oh, we can pick one. The hero gains ethereal-infused attacks. Their attacks now deal ethereal damage instead of physical. They can still crit strike, gain additional damage from bleeds, and both lifesteal and magic steal affects ethereal-infused attacks. But when the fight starts, the hero loses 20% attack damage. When they get below 50% max HP, they gain a shield. And the hero gains 25 ethereal. Yeah, let's do... Maybe we do a shield on this? Though they gain additional damage from bleeds. I don't think I'm bleeding anybody with this character. So we're just going to go with the overheat shield. Oh, there you go. Very nice. And then let's get you up as well. When the hero is... gets or below 50% max HP, they inflict bleed. Every crit strike, the hero deals additional ethereal damage equal to their defense to the target. I don't know if that's a high defense or not. It is... it's okay. It's... no, actually, it's kind of low, I think. On cast, the hero gains 12 spell power. We can do... let's do crit strikes, right? We're doing all these crits. And then who else do we want to... maybe our healer... could stand leveling up. The wearer gains attack damage equal to 45% of their spell power. It stacks up to 100. Where's spell power? Mana, health. I think a spell power is something they gain. All heroes gain 2 spell power. But I don't think they don't have... there's not like a base spell power. I don't see. Every 4 attacks, if the hero is below 50% HP, we don't want that. You're going to be in the back line. You're not going to be taking damage, hopefully. Every time the hero casts their active ability, 2 random heroes receive 1 mana. Let's go with this. And then we got one more, which we can give to somebody, but we're just going to hold off. And we're going to deal with these Reapers. Targets the hero with the lowest HP with a Death Nado, dealing 100 spell damage to all heroes. Okay, we need to split up here, perhaps. So let's go like this. Oh yeah, we can't put him in that range. We're going to go here. We're going to go here. You guys are going to take care of this down there. And actually put you there like that, and you're just going to support in the middle and see how that does. Oh no, the Death Nados. That was awful. We're going to heal though, which is great. All right, we got it. And we got all our lovely summons going on. Pick an item. We have every attack the wearer gains 50 max HP, stacks 15 times. I should take a look. Wait, can we go back out of this? Oh, I want to see who is taking the most damage there. Plus 50% ethereal amplification. When the fight starts, the wearer gains plus 40% max HP. It does not count as a heal. The wearer gains 50 max HP, stacks 15 times. I mean, that sounds great. The skeleton shield. We're gonna go with that. Okay, here we go. You were taking bunches of hits. So we are going to go... we're gonna forge this, right? And we're gonna forge... what do you have on you? You have the novice bow. We're just gonna forge it with your novice bow that you currently have. There we go. And place this back on you. And let us proceed. Head off to this battle. Combat. Heroes do not die permanently. They revive after each fight. Hero deaths make you lose flame. If you lose a fight, your run is not lost, but you get less rewards and no bonus rewards. For instance, an elite fight that usually rewards an extra hero and relic won't be granting these on a lost fight. Bosses make you lose increasing flame for each subsequent death. You lose the run if you get defeated by a boss. Enemies get stronger from ranks and power level. Enemies will have higher rank as you progress throughout the run. The rank is shown as a numerical value on the health bar. Power levels go from 0 to 4. Ranks and power level increases the enemy's HP, attack damage, and spell damage. Additionally, power level also increases the enemy's tenacity, more resistant to stuns. You have a fight timer here for Enrage. Enemies have Enrage timers. Their power increases after some time. You can learn more about Enrage timers and hero deaths by hovering the fight info icon in the bottom right corner. You can right-click on a hero or an enemy during the fight to open their panel and see their attributes updating in real time. That's really cool. Alright, we have a big Uzi guy. Summons a slime that has 33% of its max HP and 50% of its max or of its attack and damage. The slime has no ability. You're awful. Cast defensive ritual, granting itself and nearby enemies 40% damage reduction. Oh, you're super awful. I want to target you first. Let's go kind of like this at you, and then you can go here as well. And you're attacking at like a range, aren't you? You're summoning drakes. You're gonna be in the back. Hey, you over here, fight me. And I don't like this. I honestly don't like this at all. This feels bad. Let's go. Oh, they're getting wrecked over here. Heal. Very good. Okay, get you down, the defensive guy. Okay, we got it. Now we only got their ranged enemies down. Although we lost Gerald. Poor Gerald, you're back. How you doing? Alright, okay, we got another recipe here. 10% attack speed. Every 2 attacks, the wearer heals for 5 times the amount of bleed and frost on the enemy. Somebody is inflicting bleed. Yeah, you inflict bleed here. When the wearer receives damage from any source, they have a 25% chance to bleed to all enemies. To all enemies? Ooh. Every second of the wearer deals additional ethereal damage equal to 60% defense. I think I like Blood Knight's armor. They receive damage from any source, 25% chance to bleed. I mean, that sounds great. Of course, we need to forge this with something. The pistol. Oh no, the pistol hasn't been forged. So we're gonna have to, I can't get to this behind it. 8 crit strike chance, 50 strike damage, 12. So maybe we use the short dagger and this, and then we move it to, who was it now? Naka? All right, let's get out of here. Oh, we can level up, right? We should be doing that as well. And we should be getting, who's close? You here. Every attack, the hero has a 15% chance to stun its target. That sounds great. Every crit strike, the hero's crit strike chance is increased by 1.5% per summon on the battlefield. Oh, that's great. We're doing summons, aren't we? You're already at 30. Every attack, the hero gains 4% attack speed. Stacks reset when changing targets. We're gonna do this, right? We got the summon game going on. And then who else? Anybody? You're not close at all. But we do have 7. So yeah, let's go ahead and just get you up. We're using a lot. Gains 8 defense for each hero and summon. That's great, but you're in the back line. So I'm not too worried about that. For every missing, again, you're not going to get hit, hopefully. So ethereal damage. Additional damaging effect that is generally dealt after an attack. It is represented as teal in the damage meters. So it's just extra damage that we're doing. Attacks deal additional ethereal damage equal to spell power. And here you're gaining 4 spell power per summon on the battlefield. So I think this sounds good. We're going to do that. And then we're going to use our remaining, we have 15, which is not going to get anybody up to another level. So we're going to hold on to them for now. And we're just going to proceed, and we're going to go to the campfire. Origins are global and permanent team buffs or effects. Picking and swapping origins is free. Elixir Master. Every 6 seconds, the hero with the highest max HP gains max HP equal to the team's attack damage, and then heals for half that amount. Heroes and effects inflict twice the amount of frost. I don't think we're doing frost. I mean, we have somebody who's doing frost, right? You're doing frost on your active. All heroes gain plus 5% heal received for every mana regen on all heroes. For every summon on the battlefield, all heroes gain 15% shield received. Ooh, I think we're going to this one. Every 4 seconds, all summons gain attack damage. I think we're going that one. Every 4 seconds, all heroes receive a heal equal to 200% of the team's max mana. Gain ethereal amplification equal to 40% of the team's spell power. No, we're going angel. Let's do that. That sounds great. And break time. Finally, some time off from slaying monsters. By default, you can perform 2 actions in the camp in total per campfire. We can heal our flame, which we're doing great at, or we can enchant, upgrade a rare item into an epic item. We lose 15. Okay, so we're going to enchant and then rest, right? What does upgrading to an epic do? You can preview the epic version of an item by holding shift. Yeah, let's go. So it just increases the effect down there. You gain more HP. A 50% chance to bleed. I think I like that one. Or dealing 2 damage. That's great as well. Per summon. Oh, these are all great. I think I go with this one, the Blood Knight's armor. Oh, I like the little animation. That was great. We could do it again and risk it. I don't know. Let's risk it. Let's do it, because I think we're in the tutorial missions, right? We're going to be fine. We're going to be fine. Let's go all out. I want the sharp saber. Let's go. 57 out of 90. No worries. Let us proceed. Actually, maybe worries. We have an elite in the boss, right? But we do have another. If we don't do well on this elite here, or this star, actually, it's a star. Slightly harder encounter that rewards a bonus reward of your choice if victorious. 15% attack speed buff. This rewards a relic. Okay. Physical damage is done through auto attacks and can be increased by attack damage, crit strikes, and bleed debuff. Spell damage is generally done through active abilities and can be increased with spell power, the frost debuff, and by increasing the rate at which you cast your active ability. Ethereal damage is done through items and effects. It can be increased by ethereal amplification and the burn debuff. Oh, look at that. Spell damage, physical, shield, heal. Meters are in per second. I'm not going to remember all that, but let's go. Look at you, Skeleton Archer. Whoa, 5790. Gains 15% attack speed for the remainder of the fight. Okay, yes. Who's got the biggest health? Zephys over there. You're going to be the last one in, for sure. Right there. Get all y'all in the back here, and let's get it. Yep, heal up. Very nice. Okay, we lost. We lost our big boy, but it's fine. We get this. We get to pick an item. Attack speed, max HP. I mean, maybe max HP is good for Zephys over here. Spell power and mana regen. Could be good as well, maybe for our mage character. Let's go guard's armor and a mana regen, attack speed, and spell power. Interesting, 75 spell power and plus 2 max mana. Am I reading that right? It's red. I assumed it would be negative. But plus 2 max mana sounds good. Yeah, I don't know why that would be bad. A mana regen. Let's go with a novice wand. And let's put the novice wand on you. And we're going to put a little more health on you. 1670. Sounds great. And let us proceed. And we're going to head to this star. I mean, the event sounds good too, but this leads us to potentially another campfire. If we need it. Oh, what did I do? Oh, that was my mistake. Well, we're getting it. I didn't mean to click on that. It looks like we're winning anyway. Despite it. Yes. Alright, we get this, we get an item, we get a reward. Plus 15 spell power. Mana regen equal to how far they are from other heroes. Ooh. 10% crit strike chance. The wearer gains 30% attack speed and 30% lifesteal for 10 seconds, but loses 550 HP when the fight starts. Ooh. Let's go with the regen scroll here. Choose a reward. Swap two passives between your heroes. Oh, that's very interesting. Allows you to change a passive on a hero from three other random passives or keep the rerolled passive. Oh, I like that. So you don't have to change it, right? Like, you can get three random and you're like, nah, I want to keep what I have. You can keep what you have. Choose one of three heroes to join your party and gain four trophies. I think I want this. It said we could have five, right? Heroes on the battlefield, so maybe we're fine. Where preparation phase? Yeah, you can have up to five heroes on the battlefield. So maybe I don't need another hero. I'm going to keep with what I have. We're going to reroll a passive, I suppose. I like that. Deal additional ethereal. They gain a shield. This one's okay. Every crit strike, you get a summon. The wearer gains attack damage equal to 40%. This one's okay too. Rose is our healer, right? So I don't think you're doing a bunch of damage to begin with. So maybe we try this one. Heroes' attacks have 50% chance to rapidly attack an additional time. Every time the hero crit strikes. Every two attacks, inflict shock. Every time the hero stuns a target, they inflict one shock to all enemies. Let's try this one. Electric attacks. And we are going to proceed. If we lose on the boss, it doesn't matter how much flame we have. So let's take a look at the shop. Hello, shop. Oh, we can get new characters. Whenever the wearer gets a shield. Like, one of the more, like, I'm looking at the more expensive ones. Gains 10% attack damage per summon. Yes, I kind of like that. Titan Slayer. Every second, all summons gain 12% attack speed. Whenever the wearer attacks, all summons lose 6% attack speed. So it depends on how fast, like, we're all attacking. Let's do this. And these are recipes, so we need to add them to an actual item. So I would just want to pick some kind of cheap item, I guess, because I kind of want the Titan Slayer as well. Gains shield, one attack, magic steel. 2% chance to frost or burn. Yeah, I kind of like this. Let's grab this. And then let's try and find... I mean, the pistol is great. Yeah, let's do pistol. And then just something small. I guess the stone mace. And then we come in here, we can forge. Oh, we have another one as well. Oh, I forgot about this one. Alright, let's put this with this. And let's put, okay, who is holding these? So this, who is that? Is that Gerald? That is Gerald. Oh, I guess I haven't even been looking who's been doing the most damage. But we'll give it to Gerald. We gotta re-equip it anyway. And then the mana regen on the wand. Sure. You get a regen scroll. You get, you're coming over here with the heal. You can have that. We can give this to you, and attack speed, crit strike chance. Let's go up over here. We're actually over here, 34% on you. And then we can also, can we do trophies in here? It doesn't seem like it. Click to enter, leave trophy mode. Click on a hero. Middle mouse click while hovering over a hero will give a trophy. Even works while not in trophy mode. Can I do it? I can't do it from here either. Oh man, I think I had to have done it. I think I needed to do it at the end of that last battle. Or can I do it here? No, my heroes are not here and I can't do it in this panel. Okay, well, we're going to proceed. I can probably do it during the setup. Hopefully. Heroes and enemies always target the closest hero with their auto attacks, but what about their spells? Some spells have specific targeting. For instance, cast X on the current target, cast X on the furthest enemy, cast X on the lowest HP hero. However, most spells don't have specific targeting, in which case they will use the best targeting. Best targeting will prioritize the highest number of targets within the spell area. If the highest number of targets are the same, the closest group to the caster will be prioritized. Taking advantage of best targeting system is crucial to hit as many enemies with your spells, as well as impacting the fights by cleverly positioning your heroes to split the damage from enemies' spells accordingly, and manipulate where the enemies cast their spells. Line best targeting spells work similarly to circular spells, with the exception that line spells each have different ranges. Some have short ranges, in which case it will hit the highest possible amount of targets. Here's a summary of the best targeting system. While learning the game, it is recommended to keep the fight speed at x1 to learn the spell ranges and area of effect sizes. I have not even been paying attention to that, honestly. I should be. Tutorial complete. You successfully completed the tutorial. You can now continue your run. You will need to beat the bosses of all three acts to win the run. Winning the run on difficulty will unlock the next one. Don't forget that you can open the guidebook at any time in the bottom right corner. Very nice. Okay, so we have a big old boss here, Rash, with 11k. Call the troops. Every 8 seconds, Rash calls the troops, summoning 4 of Rash's mercenaries. Mercenaries have a bunch of HP, attack damage, they taunt, and corruption. Increases the damage taken by 1% per stack from all enemy damage. And all the mercenaries die when Rash dies. You have Doomstrike, 620 spell damage, split between its target and nearby heroes. Okay, let us come over here and let us level up. Who can we level up here? Let's go with you. Oh, you're gonna need an extra one? That's awful. Attack damage, crit strike chance. I mean, we want you to have crit strike chance for sure. And you can get there. And maybe we go, let's go with attack speed on you. And I don't think we have enough to level anybody else up. But we're just gonna slam it anyway. And then we're going to, what are these marks down here? Those don't look good. we're gonna kind of, we want to bunch people up together a bit. You have this equal to how far they are from the heroes. So you want to be kind of far away, but I don't want you too far away that you're going to get hit by these summons. All right, let's just do it like this. Get our own summons going. Get our healing. Yeah, you're in the healing range, which is great. Oh, there you go. Yeah, you're getting hit by the summons. But good. Yeah, I wanted you in range of the healing circle, which is great. Oh, we got double summons going on. Oh, it's awful. But we got him. Let's go. Get a gift. We get another hero. We have Nox. 5% crit strike damage per bleed on the enemy. Executes his target, dealing a guaranteed crit. Every 20% missing HP, the hero gains 1 mana regen. Molten Shield, taunting his target, dealing damage to nearby enemies and inflicting burn. Plus defense. When the hero gets or is below 50% max HP, they inflict a bleed. 8 bleed to all enemies. There's a cooldown of 7 seconds. Silas casts Bat Storm, leeching the HP of nearby heroes and enemies. Oh, that sounds bad. The amount of leech from enemies is increased by 3% per bleed. From heroes is capped down to 40% of their HP and only occurs if Silas isn't full HP. I mean, we do have a healer, so that might be okay. I do kind of like you as a tank, taunting and then gaining more mana regen as you go along. Of course, we were having the whole crits with the bleed going along, and bleeds scale with attack damage and crit strikes. So let's just go with Nox here. Pick an item. Ooh, Dragon's Blood Necklace. Crit strikes done by any hero inflicts a bleed on all enemies. That's what we want. Plus crit chance. The wearer gains Omni Crit. What is Omni Crit? I can't. Middle mouse button doesn't do that. When the wearer gets below 40% HP, they gain 100% bonus defense of all other heroes once per fight. This item is only operative when the wearer is the top damage dealer of the party. Okay, that's very important there. Let's grab that. Who is doing our most damage? It looks like... who are you? Are you Naka? Yeah, looks like Naka here is doing the most damage. 218 total. So we want to put that on you. Pick a relic. When you obtain a rare recipe, there's a 25% chance that it gets upgraded to an epic recipe. The shop no longer offers epics, and they're replaced by rares. You have a 65% chance to obtain a legendary recipe reward from elite fights when victorious. Gain 6 flame after each fight. At the start of the fight, you gain happy fish or angry fish, depending on your current flame. When missing less than 30 flame, all heroes receive the happy fish buff. 20% attack speed. When missing 30 or more, you get angry, which gets less attack speed. So you want to have as much flame as possible. Use. Gain 75% the amount of gold that you currently own. One use only. Oh, interesting. We get like a big increase. This, I like this here from elites. And I also kind of like this. As long as we don't go down below... as long as we don't hit 60. 60 and below. And we're gaining 6 after every fight. Let's go Stinky Fish. Let's roll the dice. We can forge this onto the Stone Mace. Which, is that Naka? Does he already have that? Put that on you. You get more attack damage. So hopefully you'll be doing, 116. That sounds amazing. Okay, anything else we need to do? We can level up. We can level up Naka here. And we can give him just more attack speed or more attack damage. I don't know which one will do, will result in more damage done. Crit strike chance is great as well. You're only at 18 though, so maybe I don't want that. Let's do straight up damage. We're gonna do straight up damage on you, and then anybody else close. I mean, you can probably and get some right here. Mana regen, magic steel is interesting. Let's go mana regen. We have 7 left over. Let's get you up. I think I like lifesteal on you. You're kind of our tank. And 2 left over. We're just going to save it. And we're going to proceed. I guess we can always use it on a new character. Our new hero to get them up to par with where our current heroes are. Act 2, the Petrafi Desert. All right, what do we got going here? We got some campfires. We got a shop, a bunch of events. We haven't done any events yet. So I feel like, actually, we can go this route. No, we want to go this route. We have a campfire here at the end. We can grab we can grab one. Yeah, we can go like this way and then this way. Seems good. Let's do that. Oh, look at all these Reapers. It's the tornado thing, right? What's it called? The Deathnado. That's right. Which is awful. So let us, we're gonna split some of this up. Like this? Oh, I see. What am I doing? I'm trying to move them around. And then I kind of want to, yeah, take the focus on you and kind of get you centralized here so you can heal. Hopefully that heals everybody here. Of course, I need to plop you last. All right, let's try this. See how this goes. Okay, heals up. One down, 2 down. More heals, let's go. You're doing the most damage, which is great, which is what we want. All right, oh, look at all this. Oh yeah, oh, stinky fish, juicy mango. Pick an item. More spell power, more defense, attack speed, and attack damage. I like that. And then attack speed, crit strike chance, 8%, max HP. We're gonna go stone mace. So we can't sort of deforge anything, can we? I don't think we can. Or like forge an extra recipe on something that doesn't have anything. So that is important as we go along. Cause yeah, so the Dragon's Blood Necklace is gonna have this 20 attack damage and 200%, 200 max HP on it, like all the time. We're gonna put this over here. We're going to put this, I guess, on you. Maybe down here, actually. And then, can we go into trophy mode? And we can't get anybody up, I don't think. Oh, maybe you. No, almost. Oh, two off. Let us proceed to the next fight. We have a giant bat here. It is, I looked at it and it says it's a giant bat. I didn't think it was actually called a giant bat. Deals 350 spell damage to his target, heals for 350. And then, ooh, who are you? Skeleton Warlock casts Shatter on the two furthest heroes, dealing 280 spell damage to them and nearby heroes. Oh, you have 5k in health? Okay, you're awful. We're gonna focus on you first. Everybody in the back, you're farther back. We'll put you way back here. And yeah, we'll handle this, no problem. Oh, you're doing the most damage now though. Oh, there we go, we're swapping back and forth. Okay, there's the amulet. Okay, reach rank 4, pick one. The wearer gains attack damage equal to 45% of their spell power, 8 defense for each hero and summon within 3 hex range. Every 4 seconds, the hero deals additional splash ethereal damage equal to 100% attack damage and inflicts bleeds. We're gonna do the bleeds because we're doing lots of bleeds. Let's grab this. Every 5 attacks, the wearer receives a shield. Every 2 attacks, the wearer gains 1% crit strike damage for each burn and shock on an enemy. The wearer's crit strikes inflict 1 burn. We're just gonna do that. We're gonna do the trident. And yeah, see, unfortunately, I like what you have on here. Like, maybe I can take this off. And we're gonna forge up this trident to put on you. And we're gonna use the pistol here and forge that and drop it there. And then I think we're good with that. We have 4 trophies that we can get. Not gonna get anybody up. So we're gonna proceed. We're gonna hit the shop or hit this, the star. I kind of like the idea of a bonus reward. Let's do it. Let's try it. Oh my, what are these? Stone demons. And we have more skeleton. Okay, this was a mistake. Never mind. I made a horrible, horrible mistake. Come down here. Actually, let's set... Set like this. Get the healer here. You're back here. You're going to get hit double by everybody. I don't know. I don't know about this fight. We got to get some good heals going on here. A lot of summons. Okay, take down their back line. Okay, we're good. We're good. Oh, you're doing so... Joanna doing so much damage now. Mana regen. The wearer loses 300 HP when the fight starts. That might not be bad on Joanna, really. Because we have her in the back line. Wearer loses 30 HP per second. Minus 100 max HP. Every 2 attacks, the wearer gains 1 additional mana. Okay, we're going to go with the Warlock's Book. We're going to get a reward. Choose a hero. We do gain 4 trophies out of this. I think I'm fine with the passives I have, honestly. Let's do this. We have Zots. Attack damage equal to spell power. Fires arrows of thunder. Inflicting shock. Ooh, look at you. Akar with your wolf. Every crit strike the hero heals for 3% of the hero's max HP. All summons by 1%. Akar starts the fight at max mana. Akar summons 1 wolf up to 2 wolves. Yes, we're doing summons. So we're grabbing Akar here. Do I want to replace anybody on the battlefield with Akar? I mean, you do summons. You got a lot of damage. You're our healer. I mean, Gerald, maybe? Nearby heroes gain crit strike chance for 5 seconds is great. And that's been going off. I don't want to replace anybody. Everybody's been doing great. Joanna does the most damage. Okay, sorry, Akar. You're part of the team, but you're not on the strike team, as it were. We do have 12 trophies. I was going to use them to get you up, but we could get somebody else up, like you over here, to get a new passive here. At any time, if the hero has at least 200 a shield, I don't think we're doing shield. Attack damage equal to spell power. Lifesteal equal to 15% of their defense. I think I like a lifesteal. We're going to get that. And... We can increase somebody by, what, 25? Which does not get anybody up to another level. So we're just going to proceed here. And we're going to go... I want to go to this event. See what that is. We get an origin. So we have multiple origins. Picking and swapping origins is free. Does this replace our current one? Because I like our current one. I don't want to replace it. I have a feeling it will. Oh, reroll all the available origins. For every 100 HP healed, all heroes gain 3% shield. Whenever a hero gets below 55% HP, they gain 35% attack damage and lifesteal. All heroes gain lifesteal equal to 0.5% max HP of the highest HP hero. All heroes gain crit strike chance equal to the team's bonus mana regen. 1.5% attack damage for every stack of frost. Every 3 seconds, the lowest HP hero receives a heal equal to 1% of its max HP for every bleed on the enemy. We are doing a lot of bleeds. Okay, I'm going to pick this. I hope it doesn't replace our summon buff. Oh, there you go. Yes, no. What does this do? Every 4 seconds, all summons gain attack damage. Equal to shield, for every summon on the battlefield, all heroes gain plus 15% shield. I'm keeping the angel, honestly. Yeah, I'm keeping the angel. So we're not grabbing that. We are going to... We don't need to heal. We can enchant. We can enchant and then heal, I suppose. Oh, we can... hold on. We can hold shift. Oh, plus 10 strikes chance as well. 2 mana. More HP. We lose more HP. Oh, we don't have this equipped on anybody. It's not even, it's a recipe that we haven't even crafted yet. I feel like the Blazing Trident is the way to go. And then let's rest. Let's heal that back up. And then proceed. And hit this event. Oh my, look at this. Gargoyle statue. You discover a massive gargoyle statue in the middle of the desert. The gargoyle statue clearly holds something in its hands. It might be valuable. This is bad. This is a trap. Don't touch it. On the other hand, the statue seems to be channeling a strange spell, which might be dangerous. You can also try to search around it for other treasures. I want to search around. Find a heirloom and 5 trophies. Attack the statue. If victorious, your chest reward will contain a legendary recipe. The statue does not attack, but if not destroyed within 20 seconds, it will spawn deadly enemies. I mean, okay, we're at over an hour now, so we're going to be ending the video soon. Let's do it. Let's just go. Rush the statue. Oh my, you are awful. Okay, so, I mean, you don't attack. We're just gonna send everybody up here. Within 20 seconds. Can I see? I can't even see how much health it has. Go. Where's okay, there's a timer. Okay, we're doing okay. Halfway there, we're at like 9 seconds. Maybe we're good. 15 seconds. Oh, we got it. Let's go. We get some coinage, we get a bunch of stuff. Pick an item. Sanguine Ring. Every 5 seconds, the wearer stuns their current target for 0.2 seconds per bleed. The wearer gains infinite range, but their taunts are no longer effective. Every second, the wearer gains... Wait a minute. Gains infinite range. Taunts are no longer effective. The wearer gains 2% attack speed and 2 spell power for every hex range between them and the closest hero or enemy. This... I was about to say, this helmet looks familiar. It's literally called Wanderbot's helmet. That is amazing. Holy cow, I have to pick that just because. Every 4 seconds, the wearer receives a heal equal to 25% frost on their current target. I'm picking the helmet. Of course I am. that was really cool. That was nice. I love that. This game is great. The Last Flame, once again, on the Steam page, it's set to release on January 17th, and there is a free prologue that is coming out on January 8th. That you can download and play for free. Try it out yourself. There's a demo currently that you can do as well, but the prologue will have more content than the demo has. And I will have links to both the full game and the prologue in the description down below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe. And if you made it this far, thanks for watching.